Welcome everybody here to your live stream on this wonderful Saturday night. We're doing the HyperX Trilogy Tour, and we have our lower bracket consolation final. We do our grand final tomorrow night. Winner of this series will be going up against Moscow 5. They've already won the right to go into the grand final, so they're going to be a best of 5 with the one game advantage going the way of Moscow 5. While Power Rangers and Team of Spirit, the last ones left alive, Power Rangers taking out one of my favorites for the competition, which was Hellraisers. They went out last night in a, well, an unfortunate fashion for Power Rangers, for Hellraisers, as Power Rangers really just, apart from like the first 10 minutes of the game, where it looked like Hellraiser was doing really great, Power Rangers just dominated everything else in the entire series. So, at this point, I'm looking forward to seeing how Power Rangers come in tonight. If they play like they did last night, I'm almost predicting a 2-0 victory going their way. But Team Aspera are no mugs with a hit couple of heroes, and they picked up one of my favorite heroes as well, and that is going to be the Invoker. So, yeah. This is for me always one of the greatest heroes in my mind. He's the perfect all-rounder. He's teamfight control. He's also like range sniping as well, like because you get your technically if you go if you go for the early points up in Exord, then you've got combinations with other lanes, which mean it always just have that raw burst damage that's required. But yeah, it's one of those things. It's one of those things that just I love him. I absolutely love him. Witch Doctor and Brewmaster, though, Brewmaster, great teamfight controller as well. Witch Doctor, he, in a way, he is exactly that too, especially lane controls. He's a perfect hero up against, surprisingly, a Wisp pickup that comes up after you select the Witch Doctor, primarily because when Wisp tethers up and relocates in, you remove any ability to move out. You know, if my brain can start functioning, I can use the English language correctly, then we can start talking about this thing properly. So yeah, relocate him. You got your paralyzing cask going to stop the heroes from moving out from each other because the bouncing cask will always control you. You then have the death ward, which will instantly make you want to run yourself away, even if you're trying to get in. Disruptor now adds another level of team fight control. This is actually across Wex Invoker, and we look at tornado style build coming up from the Invoker. He could use that to set up for the Disruptor. But Disruptor's also a great hero up against heroes like a Batrider, where you think you've come out far enough, and then all of a sudden, it doesn't really work that way. You get dragged back through the glimpse, and you'll find yourself dead in a matter of no time. Same thing for the Wisp. Is that perfect counterpick again, where you've got a relocate in, and then you've got Disruptor ultimate, you've got a wall up as well, and it's basically guaranteed kills coming out, which means I'm hoping Power Rangers just use this as more of a buff-up hero to their core. They grab something more like Phantom Assassin and just have the Wisp sitting on the back of it and making sure it's more powerful. They might look for some level of teamfight control themselves, like a Gyrocopter, but the whole Gyro Wisp is a little bit more archaic. It doesn't work as well, primarily because of Flat Cannon's long cooldown timer. You burn through it and there's nothing left. So they go for a Tiny. It's still more of a relocate-in hero. And I'm still very concerned that the Tiny is going to get controlled, and Medusa as their last one. So we get an offlane Brewmaster coming out from Aspera, or potentially aggro tri-lane with Medusa, Disruptor, as well as Witch Doctor. I wouldn't blame them if they tried it, primarily just because, well, you've got so much ability just to force out a lane. When Wisp was going to do nothing against you, Vengeful Spirit's got one stun. If she comes in close, you got Thunderstrike, you got Paralyzing Cask, and you've got, depending if you do go the Snake build from Medusa, you do have that burst damage from her as well. So right now, I'm liking Team Aspera's lineup, and hey, Invoker Sunstrikes, they'll get the last little pickoff you're searching for. But that means he's not going teamfight control, but I think we've got enough of that. Between Brewmaster split, because if they went aggro tri-lane, then you got Brewmaster versus a Tidehunter, and that will favor a Tidehunter. Tidehunter will more than likely always be favored when it, well, more than likely, in my mind, he's always favored in melee matchups. There's only a few times when he would not work in the melee matchup, but that's very, very rare. I realized too, after my little gaming with Sing Sing, we have to do this, we have to do this. And in case anyone is watching from inside the game, greetings to you if you are watching from inside the game, if you somehow managed to find the Dota TV lobby. It's free to watch inside the Dota TV. If you are tuning in through Dota TV, then congratulations, you got yourself a freebie. There's no item drops for this one because it's still just a custom private lobby. HyperX Trilogy Tour is not on a Dota TV ticket. Alright, so we start to see normal strats here from Power Range. When you got yourself a Wisp, you just cut the tree line off here, which means J4 can do the stacking. He even went VS Hal first yesterday because he was, well, you Hal this camp and then you attack this camp and they both move up and you're capable of doing double stacks. We ended up having a triple and a quad stack by 5 minutes into the game. Where are they? Is this coming in for a gank? You're gonna have Brewmaster? Yeah, okay. They're aggressively posturing so they can control the top rune. They're not gonna get the bottom rune because you've already got three heroes waiting for them. It is gonna be in a Spear defensive lane with Witch Doctor Disruptor as well as Medusa. Middle lane is the Invoker, no surprise there. What build is he actually looking at? No, hasn't decided yet, but we got early Null Talisman and a couple of Tangos. I'm still not gonna say that that decides everything. But they do put an aggressive Observer Ward up in the high ground Power Rangers, so they'll know whenever any heroes, well, I say whenever any heroes try and rotate up towards the top lane, but if they do, they're going to smoke up in the trees down in this little region here and then move themselves up. We actually got a line being drawn up by Disruptor saying, can we please move up? They might try and go for a Courier Snipe. That's a possibility. The Wisp, okay, that's the reason why they secured it. Really smart. Really smart. So they secure the first rune, the 100-100 rune, because the extra gold, because it gives the Wisp an instant bottle. So he's purposefully coming forward to take damage, so then he can regenerate up on the Tani. J4's going to try and brawl up against Brewmaster. Brewmaster will win this one, J4. You won't come out on top of this, because he's trying to battle it out by using Wave. So you drop the armor down at the Brewmaster, so your physical DPS has some effect, where normally it wouldn't. So that's actually allowed him to trade evenly with the Brewmaster. But it's the Drunken Brawler with the miss chance as well, and his crit chance. And the funny thing is he also cancels his attack at the other point. Well, I'm actually gonna go for this. When you got negative 5 armor, they can get a kill here. One more attack from J4 will do it. The salve will come, actually the salve gets cancelled as well. This is a horrendous lane now for Aspira. The Brewmaster off lane, he's got no escape mechanisms, and J4 again with this wave of terror first has just he has chosen correctly. This guy should have been there for the Holy Grail. Then we wouldn't have to have that guy die in a horrendous way, which gives me nightmares forever. Cheshire Cat able to pick up 3.5 levels already on this off lane. So for a defensive tri lane, they haven't reduced the farm rate of the Batrider. Like, he's 5-0, he's found levels, they're not pulling it back, Brewmaster. Okay, looks like they dived all the way in, jet into the trees. Spends all of his cash before he dies, but he still gets first blood over to the Vengeful Spirit. He's now up to 2.5 levels. Demised. I think the ping came out asking Invoker for a Sunstrike, but this Invoker has gone the Quas build. Surprisingly too, well, maybe not surprisingly, he did go for Invoke as his, that's his second ability, and it will be a Quas Wax. So we're looking at Hunt build Invoker. More than likely, he's just going to stick with the Quas Wax and then go into Orchid build. Run around inside that Ghost Walk and find kills wherever he possibly can. Medusa's still finding good farm on the bottom lane, so even though Batrider did find levels, he hasn't for the last minute or so. Not that that really matters. How's our stacks looking? We got Trip Stack. Wow, this really is too easy. Sneeko's just going to move back and do that himself. Because J4 has been too instrumental on this top lane for PR to, like, for when they can't move him back. Well, they shouldn't move him back. Middle lane, nice tornado, but the toss is still going to send him up in towards the air. Can't get in front, and now they're going to return. The EMP burn's going to be a bit of a pain in the butt, but it's okay. Sneeko's just going to trigger off the bottle charges. Oh, not that time. his tether ran out. Well, they're going again on top lane. No magic missile, but the wave of terror is available. There's no negative armor on him, and surprisingly J4's holding on to this. I think he's hoping for another magic missile, which he wasn't capable of achieving. And once these arcane boots arrive on the Tidehunter, I think Brewmaster's actually going to bail off this top. He's so far up, and J4 will never let him farm freely here. And with no boots, with all that money spent, well, goodbye, Invoker. It's only a 1-2 combo, yet he still got caught out with higher points up in Quas. I am surprised. I am very surprised. But it might have been just that double damage rune that was also over on that Wisp. So they found their extra DPS from that. Cheshire Cat now going for his Firefly stack farming, but then again, he's doing this without using a single point of Sticky Napalm, and he has level 4. So it's like he's purposely injuring the camps, so then he can come back later and finish them off. None of that makes a hell of a lot of sense, unless he realized he couldn't do it on the first try. But he could have with just a little bit of stacks. Alright, he's doing his prep now. I think it's a fake wisp. Just sitting there in the middle of nowhere. I think he's asking for it to be moved off so he can still keep farming it up. Looks like, okay, so he's going to farm the closer camps. And then he'll have to stack this in just a moment. Which might also be the other reason why that wisp illusion was up there. Because it would have allowed for the stacking. Right, a little bit of experience getting missed out here by the Batrider. But at the same time, he's still getting what he's looking for, and that's money early on. Nice magic missile stun, and Brewmaster already taking a little bit of harassment damage early on. And you bring in a Disruptor. This doesn't level up more than 1 point up in Thunderstrike. Because he's waiting to see if he needs the second point up in Glimpse to find himself a kill. But the Witch Doctor comes into defense. He'll have actually a better job than anyone else now. In middle lane, the EMP burn. It really is a non-factor. There's 3 bottle charges available here from the Wisp. His tether is running out though, so just redoes it. And brings the Tiny all the way back up again. So Invocus ended up dying twice, the Brewmasters ended up dying twice, and Power Rangers have a very firm control of this game. Now, the only thing they don't have control over is Medusa, and that is something which is easily solvable. Because you've already got the Tiny and Wisp getting really good momentum. Nice Avalanche. They could see him up on the high ground, toss him up, the Paralyzing Cast. This is problematic. The Tether still remains, because the Glimpse didn't pull him too far out. And then, Tiny, well, he needs mana. He's got toss. He's going to have to throw him back over towards the Wisp, if this is really going to work. And now, he does. Picks him up, throws him down. He actually just throws him in the one spot. While Wisp, there's some extra help coming in from Jay Forrest. Not enough damage to kill him. Down 25 life points, and he's going to pick up the Bounty Rune, which means instant regeneration of life points. He needs to get that mana into Tiny, as now Invoker is able to invoke up the Ghost Walk. So they cannot find him there. Whoop, don't anger the dragons. Sonika, if he dies to this, I'm going to laugh my ass off. He won't. He'll bottle charge up. But he has to go back to base now. Just because it's going to take too long to use the courier for the bottle and... Arcane Bruce is now up here on the Tidehunter. So Brewmaster can say goodbye to all of his damage. He can also say goodbye to potentially killing off the Tidehunter. Because he should never be winning on the initial damage. Like, Brewmaster could win this lane if he's just capable of brawling directly up against the Tidehunter, dropping him below half of his life, and then you can go for the clap split. And then you'd have enough damage to kill him off then. Okay, well, he drops him below half of his life. The problem is, even with 340 life points, it's still really difficult for him to kill off the Tidehunter with a split. Well, I think they just tossed in the wrong unit then. That rider, pretty low. It's just him in the jungle. The centaurs be a chasing. But that's his blink dagger. So 7.5 minutes in. Blink dagger done over on the bat rider. They really have to come down here and kill off Medusa. But I think their primary goal is just making sure Shafiq cannot get any form of momentum on this mid lane. Well, that's a nice goal. They still need to... Okay, they don't care about the Brewmaster. Like, Brewmaster's got split, but he's got to walk in to do anything. He doesn't have Blink Dagger, and he won't for a very, very long time. And if he does go rush Blink Dagger, he's a clap and split, and that is all. He can't really zone anybody out. It's already difficult enough for him to try and zone somebody out because you got that VS swap. That's when he cracks level 6, which right now he doesn't have. For all the wonderful work that the Ventual Spirit's been doing. Still been unable to crack that ultimate mark. Invoker coming up to have a look for the stacks. You'll notice that, well, things have been pulled, but he won't find an opportunity for a pick-off. And he's really hoping for that one as well. It's a low-level ghost... actually, it's not even Ghost Walk. That's just Invis Rune he's walking with. And the double damage. But you'll notice that no one's on the top. Both J4 as well as Sharshlo went back to base to heal up. And now I think it's... Yeah, they're going to look towards... Well, the Tai comes back towards the top lane because he knows he can survive here. The Invoker was scouted out by the Dire Observer Ward that's sitting on the top rune, so they know he's moving back towards the middle lane. Which means maybe Tiny should be a little bit more... No, he does have to be cautious. He's got a Wisp behind him. A Wisp is just about to hit level 6 as well. And who just did one stack. Didn't get the double off. With Batrider with his Blink Dagger. And J4 with the negative armor effect. He's prioritizing that Wave of Terror. 3 points up in the Wave of Terror. But no one's going to come close to him. Especially when they can be scouted out like this. I don't know if that blink... the blink saw him. The blink definitely saw... he definitely got seen blinking. Because of the observer ward that's in the lane. And you see just how far back a spear are moving. Like, they know they're going to become next targets. So, what do? You move back between your tier 1, tier 2 tower? Okay, I'm not sure about abandoning this far, because Cheshire Cat does exactly this. He just moves towards the mid lane. Once he fireflies, he'll be able to scout out the Witch Doctor. And he kind of needs to get... Well, he kind of needs to get both of them. Because the one stun or the other is going to slow him down. So he walks in, firefly up, blink, lasso. Where's that paralyzing cast? Now it's going to fly, but the invoker's already been dragged back way too far. He'll get to Invis, but the toss will end up killing him off. You've got the Brewmaster coming in, he'll go into the split. Wisp needs to ball charge up for his teammates, but it's not going to work in time. They've lost two heroes here, Power Rangers, and the Brewmaster sends the Titan to Rob. He does have Ravage, they've got to keep their distance here. He'll hit the ground, there's no silence. He's kind of just going to get stunned up as well as Stone Gazed up, and then J4 taking it for the team. Swaps him out so they know he's safe. The glimpse not really having much of an effect. But the Wisp Honey does go down. They did kill the Invoker for that one. But is it really worth it? Like, it was a 2-for-1 trade-off, and you just killed a mid-solo that was already pretty well crushed for your dual combo in mid. And technically, the Brewmaster ultimate you did get out, but at this point of the game, that was exactly the situation the Brewmaster wanted. Where the fight comes to him and then he can just walk into it. Cheshire Cat back to his farming. And they need his Blink Dagger. They really need his Blink Dagger. The initiation right now comes from the Batrider Lasso. That's fantastic. But he needed to zone out the Invoker a lot quicker than that. Which means he needs to have something more like a 4-staff or a higher movement speed. And because he went for basic boost to start with, he doesn't have that innate movement speed that comes from something like Tranquil Boots. So is it worth... Did he actually buy... No, he's not. That's, Nope. Hang on. Click on the right one. No, I am clicking on the right one. Yeah, he hasn't spent his money. He can buy the Tranquil Boots, but he'll have to buy it and send it out in the courier. Because he just needs the ring for that. Right now, that gauntlet we're looking at is meant to be for the Wisp as he builds into an urn. And they got more damage. Relocate. We're headed down towards the bottom lane. Lasso, as well as the toss avalanche into Medusa. It's not enough damage to kill her. They had to burn through a lot of her life points, but it will be enough at the end of the day. And they'll relocate themselves back towards the mid. But no! EMP! Tornado with wall, with death ward. Avalanche toss combo with a Ravage combo! He lives! Not only does he live, but Tiny picks up a double kill. The tether keeps him alive. The huge Ravage save there from the Tidehunter is going to end up being a team wipe with Medusa dying on bottom lane. The fourth back in mid, you instantly thought, uh-oh. The second that relocate came back towards the mid, the wall was up. The death ward was right, but there was no static storm. There was no silence, which meant that the stuns were still available. And Aspira came in way, way too close to the Power Rangers lineup. They tried to come up to the higher ground. PR knew what was coming. They had this observer ward that's still here that saw everything across the river in this area here. Didn't see up to here, but the creep wave was doing the rest of that. And the Tidehunter waltzes in and ravages up. And now Batrider even starts taking the stacks of a Spearer. Might be a little bit sad there's two Mud Golems in this, but I don't think he really gives two hoots at the end of the day. There's a huge amount of money coming in from him. That's the majority of his 4-staff, which he can now afford. And a smoke gank coming in from Bow Rangers. They know their advantage. Do we actually have Vlads? We have Medallion for J4 with Wave of Terror. Clean enough he threw it when he was outside. But he threw Wave of Terror as well as the Medallion. So negative 11 on the armor for Roshan. He'll need more help. He really needs more help to do this. But they're trying to do it in secret. So if they bring more help in... it's going to be very obvious that they're trying to go for Roshan. And because there's been no attempt for aggressive warding from a spear to put it up on the high ground, then, yeah, they don't see the wave of terror flooding over. And that's going to be Aegis Immortal into the hands of Tiny. And that's also going to be Tiny with that double kill, 150 gold away from his Aghanim Scepter. So the cleave is going to be real. The tower damage is going to be even realer. This is just a perfect situation for Power Rangers. I've been avoiding this since the fight, but as you can see, just over 5k, almost reaching 7k for the experience, is the advantage for Power Rangers, and they're hitting their sweet spot now. Their two primary initiators, not only do they have Blink Daggers now on both the Tide and the Batrider, but the Force Staff is there for the Batrider. And then you've got your Wisp Relocate ready to go with the Tiny, who's currently holding on to a tree, which... I'm so happy they fixed that animation for him. It still just looks really weird seeing a smaller Tiny holding onto that. But still, it's Aghanim Scepter tree. So he's going to start forcing down buildings across the map, while the rest of PR just batten down the hatches and then arrive if a Spearer look like they're ready to fight. Which means Power Rangers also need to bring down these Tier 1 towers so they can see when that happens. Aggressive warding then comes shortly after, and I'm looking for wards up on this hill. A ward currently actually probably a little bit deeper, like down in here. And then this one's in the perfect spot. Power Rangers threw that ward, like, I think it was like 2-3 times yesterday, and it won them so much position. What do you even do against this? You gotta fortify. Oh, that's another ball's up. Fortification was off cooldown just then, and they could have actually triggered it. It comes back off cooldown anyway, as the T1 tower goes, and Brewmaster, well, they're waiting this one out. In comes the Avalanche Toss. Not even a toss. There it was. With the relocate. Didn't even see him go up in the air. And they'll beat the T1 tower into oblivion. Wisp will just relocate back down again with the Tiny. And then they can start forcing it to the Tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. All the damage on the top lane has already been done. 12-2 Power Rangers looking so strong in this game. It looks like also Invoker. Too far behind. Way too far behind. He tries to initiate, but this is never going to work. The tornado is long, but it's very obvious when it goes in a path like that. And a hero with a blink dagger can easily escape. So a Lincoln Spear will arrive now for the Medusa. So this will at least stop the initial lasso, which could come out from the Batrider. But at the same time, I don't think it's going to end up stopping a lot of the other abilities the Power Rangers has. Okay, Shafiq is now going to know, he just revealed the fact they have a ward up in that high ground. That's the only way you could have seen him just then. Yeah, you see the ping coming out from Wisp saying, yeah, a ward is exactly there. Keep it in mind when we move across. So they just farm a little bit deeper inside the Radiant Jungle. Their dire ward lets them see nicely. You see this arc right here. Anyone that walks inside of that range will instantly be dead if they come alone. So bring friends. Are they just trying to... I don't know if we look at Hyperstone for a Tiny. If they just want to go into like an Assault Cure Us build. Or if they feel something else. Because we still don't have that Yasha. Potential like Yasha into Manta style up against Aspira. And the main reason why that kind of works nicely is because you just pound with illusions in up to the high ground. Whoop, Blink Lasso. They found the Brewmaster. You know, they just purchased that wonderful little... Oh no! Oh, this is a disaster. It's an absolute disaster. Shafiq is gonna get destroyed. I think this game is almost over. The Spearer may even be considering calling it right now. They've just lost too much. Witchdogs are gonna be lucky enough to escape out of here. Medusa, turn your back, Tidehunter. Anchor Smash and Body Block. The Radiant Creep Wave is turning against him. He could toss in right now the Wisp, but it looks like PR will remain objective based gaming. There's just nothing that can stop this ball. Like, the Brewmaster initiation would have been one of those things that might have been able to stop it. But even then, the second he bought his Blink Dagger, what was the first thing that ended up happening? He got initiated on by the Batrider. And he couldn't stop it. Like, Medusa's capable of surviving, but she's not capable of out-carrying this game. And even when she tries to come over for the ancient area, like, they've got an observer ward that's watching this. They could come up and try and contest. It will require a brewmaster jump into split. There's no relocate. Call snap going to go over on Tani, but the avalanche, it's an all five of them. He already kills off the disruptor. Now starts going for the cleave. Anchor smash removing a large portion of the damage. The death ward will go down. Remember, there's still that Aegis Immortal over on Tani. Wiz trying to keep him alive. Actually, I'll take it back. It's no longer there. Did he trigger that one before? Maybe he did. Anyway, Wisp. He sticks and he'll try and kill off this brewmaster with the VS stun and the urn charges. They got it. Did it time out? It timed out. I might be wrong. Maybe it did blow during the last engagement. But the tight hunter kills off the evoker. God, this game is all next levels of down and out. So there's that Yasha over on the Tiny. So he is just going to go straight into the Mana Style. It's just a really effective item. Even if he just leaves it as a Yasha and then goes into Assault Cuirass, picks up a Plate Mail to start with all the attack speed, that's okay. He can flash farm anything. So 3-19. This is only game number one of this best of three. So there is more to come. There is a second wind, which is potentially there. BT's over on Cheshire Cat. This guy could be anywhere now. So you've got so much global. Now, they just lost J4. He just disconnected, and I think, yeah, now Power Rangers is realizing what the hell's going on. But we're sitting at just over 12,000 on both gold and net worth as the experience to the advantage to Power Rangers. All right, it's a rough game. It's a rough game. But this is what happens when you have such lineups. Like, even Wiz, wait, no, he's... I would laugh my ass off if this could eventually be something like a Bloodstone. Oh, relocated. Let's go from the Deucer. This time the Static Storm's in a good position, and the Paralyzing Cast really screwed around a lot here with Tani. A Death Ward slowly bringing down the life points, but you just see how tanky he is. That's 2,000 life points that just went through. Brewmaster, the MP will come, but the toss up already takes one kill. The swap back on the Tani, just trying to get him away to safety and allow the rest of Power Rangers to do their work. Now they come in with that tether. He's got another bottle charge up his sleeve, which now is used, and they'll just flame break the Witch Doctor back. This is a level 8 Witch Doctor dying to a level 13 Batrider, a level 14 Tiny, and a tier 2 Tower, which days are numbered. Bottom lane, Sharshlow. Okay, is he considering jumping on the Medusa? Because he's just like, maybe the Medusa's on bottom lane. She only just came down here. So go higher ground, you got 3 people down. Just force the issue. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Full Mana Style done for the Tiny, so he did complete the entire thing. And still has another 1500 gold left after that game. As we hit the 3-2-2 mark. The biggest objective in any game. Tornado gonna fly through. A little bit off target again. Even with the Observer Ward, he actually ran that closer towards the Ancients, like they would just stick around and continue to farm it, as opposed to try and get them when they walk down the stairwell. Even then, if they did do it, it would force them into a fight, which they'll probably end up losing, because Power Rangers have their entire team here. Ravage is also available. A Refresher Orb build coming up from the Tidehunter, so PR's looking for one last engagement. The Batrider to BT himself in. Into the Firefly, and he's looking for one target. The Brewmaster's the primary one. He can see him over on the side. But if he blinks, he's going to get cast up. But that's why he's got his four staff. Jet's moving out a long way. Blink, clap, looking for the split. Gets it off as well. The Ravage actually bouncing up the Disruptor. They've got to kill him up before he gets that Static Storm off. He does get it off, but then again, you got the Tani up in there. They're going to put him down so he can finally take some damage. J4's waiting for the swap out, but it never really had to happen. Tani actually ended up having more help from the Brewmaster in this engagement. Even though right now Aspira is one kill up, they still haven't brought down the big man. And until they get him, this fight isn't worth it. They blew every single ultimate they had, and now in comes the rest of the hitting power. Toss up, Avalanche is available. He could just throw it to kill the Brewmaster, and he will do so. 3 heroes down. Medusa will get the counter pick off over on the Wisp. So we are removing one of the big buffers as Tidehunter unwillingly is pushed into the tier 3 tower. Radiant's middle tower. That's a 3-for-2 trade-off from Power Rangers. They will back themselves up and play a little bit more defensive for now. They're down there initiator. He doesn't have his lasso anymore. And the Wisp, it is a soul booster on him. But there's no reason to try and force the issue any further. The next Roshan's already spawned up as well. I think Aspira is so scared about moving out that actually we even got... Hey, I got my ward up, what I was asking for. So Power Rangers, aggressive 1 ward, aggressive 2 ward. And of course Aspira, they read that first ward up on the high ground nicely. But Power Rangers need to know where Aspira is at almost all times. Okay, so he just Fireflied in to get an observer ward behind the tower. It is out of invis range. And it's a weird ward too, like it's not something you would normally expect to be placed, but it's in perfect position for Cheshire Cat to get all the vision he needs to get a blink lasso. And they get a big early warning system as well. So they see the Medusa here, you'll have to blink and force staff the Medusa to trigger the Lincolns and then drag it back if this is going to work. But there's more support coming in, and the ward will now see Jet sitting at the back end of play. And Whisper, like, hey, where'd you end up heading to? Middle lane. Goodbye, Invoker. Hello, Refresher Orb. And Tani now will buy a BKB. He's getting sick of that Disruptor. He knows this Disruptor is... Look at the Disruptor! Where is his items? They just don't exist. Blink, lasso. Well, there's a nice little glimpse back. That ends up cancelling up the lasso. And really, Cheshire Cat should have known that was going to come. Disruptor didn't even need to be close to that. Alright. Tide scouted out Roshan, so they can go over there and pick him up. So they can put the... at this point, I don't think the Aegis model needs to go over onto the Tiny. At this point, I'd almost put it over on... Well, I don't want to say Batrider either. No, yeah, give it to the Tiny. Give it to the Tiny, because you're not going to get anything more out of the other two cores on Power Rangers. So have a second life for the Tiny. Which means Tiny can also be over-aggressive, forcing up towards the high ground with just no regard for his life, because he'll have a second one. So Wisp has his Bloodstone, 26 minutes in. Holy crap. Spear will keep fighting. They smoke gank up, they're going to look for a kill in the dire jungle. They do have that Orchid on Invoker, so this is a chance for them. They just need to find these pickoffs. They need to find some level of advantage anywhere they can grab it. One hero here, one hero there. When you've got so much experience going the way of Power Rangers advantage-wise, one kill means so much more to your team. Because you get so much back. A full Crimson Guard over on this Vengeful Spirit. I don't even know who they kill. Like, both these supports are as rich as hell. The Tide can't be killed because he's got double Ravage. You want to jump on him? You don't have BKBs. There goes your jump out. They'll send the Tiny up in towards the air, who then does the same thing over towards the Invoker as Brewmaster, taking Tiny out of this fight again. They go for the Stone Gaze, looking for the kill on the Vengeful Spirit. He's already turned on the Crimson. God, look at the cleave! Right there from the Tiny, ripping through. He's looking for more kills on this Brewmaster, but they turn over towards the Medusa. Avalanche, Ravage number one, and, well, he could go for Ravage number two, in which he will do so. That'll cancel the Death War. GG. This game is over. There's no more to be had here. Power Rangers have firmly planted the boot into the anal cavity of Aspira. This game, it belongs to the Power Rangers. So we'll go to game number two of this best of three in a couple of moments' time. The winner, if it is Power Rangers, will then get a chance to go up against Moscow 5 in the grand final. 7,000 USD up for grabs for that first place. For all the details of the tournament, you can go to join and click on that wonderful little golden text. Of course, sort your match ticker by your coverages. It works so much better. We're actually going to change that in the new year to be the default for all those people out there that also requested that. But click on the golden text in that one, and you can find all the details you want, or look at the coverage tab inside the navigation of Join Dota, and it'll also send you to the place where we know everything. Right now, I'm fairly certain they want to try and replicate their time.